Mary Ellen
down.
Tapelafon is a former Saskatchewan judge. She says an election during the pandemic
format,
is not appropriate.
Which, you know, is really painful. It's a really painful time for people to, people have stopped having ceremonies. They've stopped connecting for public safety reasons. And we're not in a mindset to be able to meet and discuss things fully at this time. And I think by winter, by fall and winter, we could be in a much better position to be able to do that.
Tapelafon wrote a letter to the AFN Executive Committee to delay it until next December, but it will go through as planned. But Tapelafon sees a downside.
As I say in my letter, to put it bluntly, the most likely outcome of following through with the current virtual election plan is an election that's less democratic, less fair, less accessible, and it will result in a weakened ability for the AFN to represent and advocate for First Nations. We could very much get a result where someone's elected and very quickly removed.
Tapelafon points out that there has never been a female national chief. No women have declared an intention to run yet, but Tapelafon says the COVID pandemic could have something to do with it.
And I found that Indigenous women and First Nations women were 4 to 5 times more likely to be get a confirmed diagnosis of COVID, and we're bearing the biggest burden of caring for people with COVID and managing safety in their community. So not only is this virtual election coming in a way that does not accommodate accessibility, but it doesn't acknowledge the position of women.
Sheila North is a former regional grand chief in Manitoba, and she was asked to run for national chief.
I have to be closer to home to be part of the healing process and going forward with my community and with my family. So that's one of the biggest reasons why I decided to stay in Manitoba.
APTN News reached out to the AFN for comment on their decision to proceed, but didn't hear back as we went to air. The nomination period for National Chief ends June 2nd, with the elections taking place on July 7th. Jimmy Pashigamska, APTN National News, Ottawa.